Half-a-day students, I am Governor Lou Leon Guerrero. You all have been through a year of big changes. We've had to adapt and make big changes to keep our families and our island safe. But with change comes opportunity and a chance to try new things like PBS University. While Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio and I will continue to do our part to keep our island safe, you students have a part to play as well. Your part is to keep learning and to keep up with your lessons. That's why I am happy to see you here ready to learn with PBS University. PBS University is a way to bring a continuous educational curriculum to you while you stay safe at home during this time. To help you keep up with your studies, we asked our friends at PBS Guam and the Guam Department of Education to put together this episode. Thank you for doing your part and have a great lesson.
PBS University is a program by PBS Guam and the Guam Department of Education in conjunction with public school teachers. These lessons are created to provide both parents and students with a unique educational experience while helping students to continue learning at home. PBS University, next on PBS Guam.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Come along, let's sing a song, we'll have a great adventure.
Today's the day, let's learn and play,
we'll have a great adventure.
Numbers,
letters,
science things, all that we can do. Help you deal with how you feel, share with us too.
It's super cool and just like school,
our awesome learning adventures. So grab a friend, the fun will end, our awesome learning adventures. Awesome learning adventures with PBS University.
Half a day, boys and girls, it's Mrs. D. Guzman, your kindergarten literacy teacher for PBS University Guam. I am here at Valley of the Latte in the beautiful village of Talofofo. Come on an adventure with me and some friends, as well as Aaliyah. Let's go!
During our adventure, we will be exploring and reading familiar and unfamiliar words. Familiar words are words that we already know. Unfamiliar words are words that we haven't learned yet. Let's make that an I can statement. I can explore and read familiar and unfamiliar words. Before our jungle cruise, we stopped by the gift shop, where we saw lots of artwork provided by local artists. Aaliyah was so fascinated by all the paintings, she was talking with Mrs. Muth about it. All right, it's time to board the boat for our jungle cruise. That's Mr. Adam. He'll be taking us on the tour. Our first stop is to visit the animals at Valley of the Latte. Aaliyah had a chance to ride on a caravel and feed some of the animals there. Hi Aaliyah, and hi Latte! Say hi to Maggette, he's a goat. And this is Monette. This is Tanu. He is a Banadu. That's how you say deer in Chamorro. And this is Nenny. She is a Babwe. They're eating banana leaves. time for a nature walk and visit the botanical gardens. During our walk, we saw lots of plants, different types of flowers and fruits. We got back on the boat, and Mr. Adam was weaving with coconut leaves, flowers, and fish for us. We fed land crabs and catfish bread. That was so exciting. We met up with the Guam Green Growth Conservation Corps, where they showed us how they removed old roots from the pineapples to replant them. Our next stop was to see an ancient Latte site and CHamoru village. Before another nature walk, Mr. Adam showed us how to husk a coconut and crack open the coconut to get some fresh coconut juice. More pretty flowers, like the red hibiscus and the yellow alamanda cup. One of my favorite moments was when we got to pick and eat some manzanita. Mr. Adam was demonstrating how the locals would crush herbs to make medicine. On our last stop, some of the ladies were showing us how to weave and make marmars. Aaliyah is helping Ernest as he tries it out. Time to go home after an amazing day at Valley of the Latte.
Aaliyah had such a fun time at Valley of the Latte, riding the boat, the caravel, feeding all those animals, and seeing so many plants, fruits, and vegetables. I hope you had fun too. Here are some of the words that we read during our adventure. Thanks for spending some time with me today. Have an adult, like an older brother or sister, your mom or dad, help you email me if you'd like to say hi, or share what you enjoy during circle time today. Have an amazing day. Be safe. Bye, boys and girls.
Half a day. And in Spanish, we say, hola. Did you know, boys and girls, that our Catholic faith was brought over to Guam by the Spaniards? Yes, the Spaniards. And they speak Spanish. So in Spanish, they say, hola. Can you say, hola? Awesome. Hi, boys and girls. It's Mrs. Muth. I am here at Valley of the Latte. And I am your kindergarten math teacher. Our lesson this week is on more or less. So let's say our I can statement. All right? I will say it first, then you, or then both of us, and then you will say it. Ready? Me first. I can tell you which is more and which is less. Your turn, say it with me. I can tell you which is more and which is less. Can you say it by yourself? Awesome. Well, being here at Valley of the Latte, we're going to learn about more or less with fruits and vegetables and animals. Are you ready? Let's do this. We're going to have a lot of fun. Come on.
This is the boat ride up the Talafofo River, having so much fun. Which is more, which is less? In Chamorro, we say, Amanu meganya, Amanu dudedenya. Let's do this Valley of the Latte style. Which is more, which is less? These are chickens, and in Chamorro, we say manuk. Get ready to point. Got it? I'm sure you did. Good job. Which is more? Which is less? These are coconut trees, and in Chamorro, we say drunkenizuk. Are you ready? All right. Less and more. Awesome. Amanu meganya, Amanu dididenya. This is Adam. He works at Valley of the Latte, and he's showing us some items that were weaved out of coconut leaves. You ready? Less and more. Awesome. Which is more? Which is less? Are you pointing? Less and more. Perfect. Which is more, which is less? There's Adam again, and he's showing us a lusong. And lusong, they used this a long time ago to make medicine. They would put leaves and herbs in there and crush it with the stone. So, which is more, which is less? Less, because it's one piece. More, because it's more pieces. Perfect. Doing great. Amanu meganya, Amanu dididenya. This is a tiba in Chamorro, and in English, of course, a goat. And then we have chickens, and in Chamorro, it's manuk. Are you pointing? Awesome! I'm sure you got it correct. With that said, here's a little clip of me feeding the tiba. I had so much fun. You're welcome.
Oh, the head is out.
That was awesome. Which is more, which is less? These are breadfruits, and in Chamorro, we say lemai. Pointing? Less and more. Awesome. Amanu meganya, Amanu dididenya.
These are Latte stones. And a long time ago, the Chamorros built their homes on top of these Latte stones. Are you pointing? Less and more. Perfect. Which is more, which is less? These are crabs, and in Chamorro we say pong lao. Are you pointing? I bet you are. Less and more. Nice job guessing which is more, which is less. These are pineapples, and in Chamorro we call them piña. Which is more, which is less? Did you guess correctly? Awesome! Watch this next clip of me picking a pineapple at the pineapple farm. It was fun!
Hi, boys and girls, it's Mrs. Muth, and guess where I'm at? I am at the pineapple farm, and I get to pick a pineapple! Look at it, how beautiful it is! And I get to try it a little later. Have you tried pineapples? I'm sure you have. And this is how pineapples look. And you get to pick it just like this. Are you ready? Here I go. Pop! Beautiful pineapple. I can't wait to eat you. Yum, yum, yum.
And here I am riding Latte, the carabao at Valley of the Latte. My visit there reminded me of growing up at the ranch. I had so much fun. So make sure you visit Valley of the Latte in the village of Talafofo. You will have so much fun, just like I did. Keep learning, having fun. Bye!
Buenas and half a day. Mabuhay, rananin, kasalelie, konnichiwa, annyeonghaseyo, nihao, aloha, and hello boys and girls. My name is Mr. Navaretti and welcome to PBS University Kindergarten Science. In today's lesson, we will be learning about food and nutrition. But before we begin, let's read our ICANN statement together. Get ready! I can explain about food and nutrition. Why is food important? Food tastes good, especially the ones we like to eat. And food also gives us energy. We need energy to move, to play, and to grow. Your body is kind of like a car, and food is like gas. If you don't put enough gas into a car, it won't move, just like our bodies. If you don't eat enough food, we wouldn't move either. We also need to feed our bodies with the right food to make our bodies function better. One way of doing that is by having good nutrition. What is nutrition? Nutrition is the study of food and how it works in your body. Nutrition includes all the stuff that's in your food, such as vitamins, protein, fat, carbohydrates, and more. It's important to eat a variety of foods, including meat, fruits, vegetables, dairy products, and grains, so you have what you need to grow and be healthy. Here's Chasey showing us some healthy local foods that you can find. Can you name them?
Pudding, next. Avocado. Milk. Chicken. Squash. Kangkong. Guava. Pizza. Green beans. Starfruit. Blackberry. Melon. Broccoli. cheese, yogurt, cereal, spaghetti, pasta, oatmeal, brown rice, wheat bread, butter, spam, almonds, bok choy, papaya, cucumber, eggplant, banana, beans, mango, eggs, corn, peanut butter, string cheese, strawberry, watermelon, carrots, ice cream, tuna.
You can also visit your local flea market to find fresh produce that are good and healthy for your body. Boys and girls, looking at all that food makes me so hungry. Say, why don't we go check out the kitchen to see what we can eat to make our bodies healthy and grow? Let's go! In my kitchen, I like to prepare healthy meals to keep my body strong. One of the best ways to keep your body healthy is by balancing out the portion of food on your plate using a healthy food plate. On your healthy food plate, you need half a plate of fruits and vegetables. You also need some meat or protein, and you also need some grain. Don't forget dairy. Well, that's all we have today, boys and girls. I hope you learned a lot about food and nutrition. Remember to always stay healthy by eating nutritious foods. Before we go, let's go ahead and sing our farewell song called Adventure Is Out There. All ready? 3, 2, go! Adventure is out there. We learn and we share. Adventure is out there. We'll show
Half a Day students, welcome to PBS University. My name is John Fernandez, and I'm the superintendent of the Guam Department of Education. These PBS University lessons are made to help you to continue learning. The teachers here prepared fun lessons on science, character education, math, English, and more. And they made it for you, the students of Guam. We're very grateful to them for their instruction. We're also thankful for you students, parents, and guardians who are watching. Remember, stay safe and healthy, and we'll see you soon in the next school year. Thank you.
Hey, hey, boys and girls. Welcome back to another episode of PBS University. I'm your kindergarten social studies teacher, Miss L, and on today's episode, we're going to talk about whatever that symbol represents. But first, let's take a look at our diversophile to see if we can say hello in another language. Let's take a look. No, you guys know that one. Well, yeah, you might know that one. Ooh, you guys might like this one. This is how you say hello in CHamoru. Hafaday. Say it again. Hafaday. Great job. Now on today's episode, we're going to figure out why that represents the world. There's two special words. Do you think you can think about it? Deals with peace and love, and someone said united. That's right, that's the first part. We're gonna talk about United Nations and how we can celebrate it today. So let's say our I can statement first so we understand what we're gonna do today. All right? Okay, say it with me. I can understand and celebrate the United Nations. Awesome job. Let's begin.
Yeah. Hey, Hannah.
Yes.
Do you know what the United Nations is?
No.
Do you want to know?
Yes.
Want to come with me and find out?
Yes.
Yes.
Why do we celebrate the United Nations?
What is the UN? Well, the United Nations is celebrated on October 24th of every year. This day represents the day that the UN was established and created way back in 1945. Back then, over 50 countries met to form the group to work together for world peace and safety, improve living conditions for all people, and to help countries get along.
Oh, that sound means it's time to talk about some facts. Okay, boys and girls, if you take a look at this emblem, this consists of a map of the world and it has olive branches surrounding it. Now, the olive branch around it symbolizes peace, while the world map represents the organization in its quest to attain world peace. This is also found on the United Nations flag.
Today, there are 193 countries that became the member states of the UN.
Wow, that's interesting. But what do people do to celebrate the United Nations around the world?
In many countries, people celebrate United Nations Day by dressing up with their national costumes or their country's traditional costumes, fly and post their country's flags, and have traditional songs and music. Some places even have parades to showcase the many different countries that are represented by people. People even celebrate with food and share their traditions with other people to share their pride and connect with other countries through peace.
Wow, I didn't know that. Thanks a lot.
And did you know there is usually an annual yearly concert held in the General Assembly Hall?
Wow, they celebrate for all those people?
Yes.
Okay, that sound can only mean one thing. Hashtag facts. Okay, boys and girls, did you know that the United Nations headquarters is located in New York City? That's right, and the General Assembly Hall is located in the headquarters. That's where everybody comes from around the world to discuss important matters about peace, safety, the youth, and getting along.
Do you know what United Nations is?
Let's play a game and see if you know the United Nations. Okay, when was the United Nations created? 1945 or 2021?
Booyah! 1945. What does the United Nations emblem represent? Peace or Greece? Booyah! Peace! Awesome! How many member states are in the UN today? 1,000 or 193? Bing! 193. Great job, boys and girls! How do people celebrate United Nations Day? By sleeping or by dressing up in traditional clothing? That's right, by dressing up in traditional clothing. Okay, when do we celebrate United Nations Day? Ding, 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 ding. That's right! We celebrate it October 24th. Okay, last one. Is the United Nations for world peace? Yes or no? No or yes? You're right! It is yes! Definite yes! Sweet job answering all those questions. You guys are all winners. Ding, 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 ding.
This is your world. Hi, boys and girls. The UN has a motto. This is your world. I hope you understood that. And now you can tell other people how exciting United Nations Day is and how you can celebrate with the rest of the world. Now, let's say our I can statement one more time to see if we really understood what we learned today. Ready?
I can understand and celebrate the United Nations.
Perfect! Awesome sauce! Okay, boys and girls, until next time, I'm your kindergarten social studies teacher. And remember, I want you to think, laugh, and love. Bye!
Hello everyone, and welcome to PBS University. My name is Mr. Candoso, and I'm going to be your kindergarten character education teacher. This week, we're going to talk about diversity. Do you know what that means? Diversity. Diversity means different. You're different from me, I'm different from you, and we're different from everyone around us. And that's okay, huh? Maybe we might even have something in common with somebody that's different from us. And I'm going to give you the perfect example of that in a book that I wrote and drew the pictures for. That means I'm the author, the person who wrote the book, and the illustrator, the person who drew the pictures. And it's called The Sihik and the Thing That Was Different. You ready to read it? All right, and we'll talk a little bit after, okay? The Sihik and the Thing That Was Different, written and illustrated by Frank Candoso. That's me!
On a warm and breezy Sunday on the island of Guam, a Sihik was flying through the skies. He fluttered around, enjoying the wind rustling between his feathers as he soared along the horizon. The Sihik was young. He had just learned to fly and never flew beyond his home, but today, he wanted to explore. As he flapped his wings faster and faster and flew higher and higher, from a distance, the Sihik noticed another being that was not like him scurrying across the land. It was different. It wasn't orange or blue like him. It didn't have tints of red or cerulean. In fact, it looked a little bit dull, with a dark shade of brown with black and white stripes that seemed to clash with the rest of its body. It wasn't flying, it had long legs, and it had a beak that was much longer than that of a Sihik. "What are you?" the Sihik asked himself. "You are definitely different from me." Curious, he flew down toward the extraterrestrial to get a closer look and to determine what exactly this thing was. The Sihik perched on a tree branch and peered through the leaves just close enough to see the unfamiliar subject, but far away enough not to be seen. He investigated. He observed this newfound creature, and he tried to make sense of what he was seeing. Unable to identify this thing, the Sihik decided to be kind and exclaimed, "Half a day!" to the animal, in which he replied, "Half a day!" Shocked, the Sihik was flustered that this thing knew his language. "How?" he asked himself. He wanted an even closer look and built up enough courage to move in and face this thing. He cautiously approached the foreigner, flew to the ground, and motioned his head downward to demonstrate that he meant no harm. In return, the dark brown, black and white striped animal stood still and allowed the Sihik to conduct his investigation. "You have wings like me," the Sihik proclaimed. "You're definitely a bird," he concluded as he determined what the thing was. "That's right," said the unknown bird. "I'm just like you, but I don't really fly. I'm afraid of heights, to be honest." Afraid of heights? The sea hick asked confusedly. What bird is afraid of heights? Me, the coco exclaimed as it chuckled. I am a coco bird, and my family and I, we are flightless birds. That means we can't fly long distances like you. Interesting, the sea hick thought. How do you know my language then? It's my language too. It is possible to have the same language as you and still look different, the coco explained. I guess that is possible, the sea hick said. Then why are you different? The coco laughed. It's okay to be different, it said. Isn't the island more beautiful and interesting because of these differences? I saw you flying in the sky. I did not think you were different for not being like me. Come to think of it, I never thought of it that way, the sea hick accepted. You're right. It is an amazing thing to be different. It makes the world more interesting. It makes it colorful, just like me. Yes, the coco said encouragingly. There are many ways we are different, and many ways we can use our differences to make a difference in the world. I have an idea, the coco said. Follow me. The sea hick followed the coco into a nearby jungle. He didn't feel scared. He felt curious. He felt uncertain. He felt unaware. He felt excited. He wondered what other things were out there and just how different they could be. As they approached the end of the trail, the sea hick could hear water gushing down a cliff and became overwhelmed with as much emotion as the roaring of the water falling. The coco guided the sea hick and separated a patch of swordgrass to reveal a whole new environment to the sea hick. Flabbergasted, the sea hick's eyes grew wide as he became elated with emotion and filled with curiosity. He saw other things, other different, unique, and amazing things. He saw a helitai. He saw a hagantasi. He saw a carabao. He saw an ababang. The sea hick realized they weren't just things. They were creatures just like him. All with different features, all different types, all different heights and widths and textures and colors. From the land to the sea to the air, all different. With each animal or fish or insect having qualities and things that made the jungle a wonderful place to live. Even with their differences, all the animals were welcoming of the sea hick. It didn't matter how he looked. They just naturally made him feel like he belonged, even if he didn't look like he belonged. This made the sea hick happy, and in that moment, he told himself he wouldn't be fearful of others based on their appearance, but that he would try to make them feel welcomed and loved no matter how they looked. It was this message of kindness that the sea hick would work to spread in his community, to embrace differences in others in order to make the island, and even the world, a special and extraordinary place to live. The end.
Did you enjoy that story? I hope you did. Didn't it have such an important message of kindness and spreading kindness in the community with those who are different from us? And that's everybody, huh? We had characters like the sea hick, the carabao, the helitai, the ababang, the hagantasi, and even a coco bird. And they're all different from each other, huh? And did you see at the end? They all became friends no matter how they looked. And that's something that we can do in our community, huh? When we're at school, in our neighborhood, or anywhere we are, we can make friends no matter how they look. Being different makes you unique, and it makes you able to do things that maybe someone else can't do, or maybe someone else can teach you how to do those things. And that's what makes being different an amazing thing, huh? I also wrote a little song called It's Okay to Be Different. Can you say that along with me? It's okay to be different. Alright, so get ready. Our friends from the story are gonna help us sing it, and make sure you sing along when it comes to the part that says, it's okay to be different. That's right. So until next time, build your character, build up others, and build a community, just like the sea hick and his friends. See you later. Bye.
It's okay to be different. It's okay to be different. It's okay to be different. It's okay if we're not the same.
Someone may look different from you, and different's not the same. They may have different hair or eyes, or come from a different place. The important thing to remember is to put a smile on your face. And whenever you see someone who's different, the difference you embrace. Differences are all around us, a different size or shape. Just remember, it's okay to be different. It's okay if we're not the same.
It's okay to be different. It's okay to be different. It's okay to be different. It's okay if we're not the same.
Be kind. Be nice. Someone's different. That's alright. Now, you might feel like you don't belong, and you may feel different too. But your differences make you unique. There is no one else like you.
You're special, and so are you.
If we make the best of our differences, there's nothing we can't do.
It's okay to be different. It's okay to be different. It's okay to be different. It's okay if we're not the same. It's okay to be different. It's okay to be different. It's okay to be different. It's okay if we're not the same.
Hafiday, my PBS University friends. Guahu si Senora Rufina. I am Senora Rufina. And half a day means hello in Chamorro. Can you say half a day? Maule. Welcome to Fun 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 with Senora. Today's lesson, boys and girls, we are going to talk about Siñente. And Siñente is feelings. Holista, huh? Are you ready? I am feeling so magub today, Famagun, because magub means happy in Chamorro. Are you feeling magub today? Malik, magubso, pagu, magubso. Repeat, magubso. The opposite of magub is tristy. Sometimes when you're sad, you're tristy. Pamagun, are you feeling tristy? Great, because I am not guf magub, so I am happy. I am going to show you some of the actions of magub. When you're magub, Pamagun, you jump for joy. Let's jump for joy because we are feeling magub. Uno, dos, tres. Yay! Malik, when you're tristy, you are sad. Maybe because somebody said something that's not nice, so we feel tristy. Sometimes I feel tristy, but guess what? Senora knows how to be magub again, and I will jump for joy. Yes! Another word for Siñente feelings is malik. Vanidoso. Vanidoso means proud for a boy. And vanidosa is proud for a girl. I am so vanidosa. And when you feel vanidosa, you dance because you are feeling vanidosa. Are you feeling vanidoso or vanidosa, boys and girls? Malik, when we show our action with vanidosa or vanidoso, we can dance. And the opposite of vanidoso and vanidosa, which is mamalo, mamalo. I want to tell you a story. When I was your age and I went to Truman Elementary School, we didn't have any lunch bell. So my family and my family packed my lunch in a paper bag. Yeah, and Senora is always so magub, but that day my lunch bag tore because my water in my lunch bag is making it wet. And my sandwich is rolling down the steps. My water is rolling down the steps. And even my snack. But guess what? My friends saw that Senora is so tristy. They helped me. And that made me so feel magub and vanidosa again. I know you have friends that will do the same thing, boys and girls. So when you're feeling mama love, ashamed, and your friends or you may be the one to help a friend out, go ahead and lend a hand. They will feel so vanidoso or vanidosa like fun, fun, fun with Senora. So I am going to give you another surprise. We are going to sing a song and we're going to show our action. Go listo ho, are you ready? Famagun, follow Senora, singing the song of Siñente. If you're magub and you know it, clap your hands. If you're magub and you know it, clap your hands. If you're MacGuff and you know it, and your face will surely show it. If you're MacGuff and you know it, clap your hands. If you're MacGuff and you know it, laugh out loud. If you're MacGuff and you know it, laugh out loud. If you're MacGuff and you know it, and your face will surely show it. If you're MacGuff and you know it, laugh out loud. Now let's do another action. If you're MacGuff and you know it, jump up high. If you're MacGuff and you know it, jump up high. If you're MacGuff and you know it, and your face will surely show it. If you're MacGuff and you know it, jump up high. Now let's do another one by shaking our body, because you're MacGuff and happy. If you're MacGuff and you know it, shake your body and jump. If you're MacGuff and you know it, shake your body and jump. If you're MacGuff and you know it, and your face will surely show it. If you're MacGuff and you know it, jump up high. Molly from the Guam, Guam Molly from MacGuff Zipago, and I am Vanidosa. Are you MacGuff and Vanidosa? Molly, great job. Let's review what we learned today on feeling Siñente. MacGuff, Tristy. MacGuff, Tristy. Vanidosa, Vanidosa, Mamahlo. Vanidosa, Vanidosa, Mamahlo. Remember, small things can make big things happen for you, for Senora, and the whole world. Si zuus ma'asi, adios hasta aquí.
Fast, fun facts. Fast, fun facts. With Mr. Ernest Ochoco.
Half a day, everyone. This is Mr. Ernest Ochoco with another fast, fun fact. And today I'm going to teach you a word, nidzuk. Can you say it with me? Nidzuk. Good job, you guys. Do you know what a nidzuk is? Yes, correct. It is a coconut. Delicious. I went to Valley of the Latte Adventure Park and I had an adventure there. We saw so many different things with a PBS cast of teachers. And we went on a riverboat cruise. We saw a recreation of an old Chamorro hut. We saw a proa. And we also got to grate some coconuts. What is grating coconuts? Well, we're gonna see it right now. Hi, Miss Ryan. I see you have the coconut shell with the coconut meat inside. That white part is the coconut meat. And Miss Ryan is going to grate the coconut. So she's removing the meat from the coconut shell. And what she's using right there is called a kumzu. That kumzu is removing the meat and falling into the other coconut shell that I am holding. Look at all that coconut meat. You can make coconut milk from coconut meat and coconut oil. What do you use coconut flakes for? Well, let me tell you what I use it for. Ooh, look at that. That's a shell that they use for the kumzu. That's what's grating the coconut. Mm-hmm. Well, I use coconut meat in my kelaguin, and also I use it for my coconut candy, one of my favorite desserts ever. Miss Ryan, you did such a great job. Bye. Thanks. I love eating coconut. It's so delicious. Do you like eating coconuts? Yes, you do? Wow. You and I are the same. Sometimes I eat it in a piggy. I also eat it in pies. I can't wait to try some. And I also love my coconut candy. Let me tell you how I make it. I fry it with just a little bit of brown sugar and butter. And I make it into a little ball. And that's how I eat it. So simple and so delicious. Well, thanks for listening to my Fast Fun Fact with coconuts. This is Mr. Ernest Ochoco. Bye, guys.
Today, students, I'm Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio. For more than a year now, you all have continued to wash your hands and watch your distance from others, and you've done a really great job wearing your masks. We know your parents and guardians have helped you to make these changes to keep yourself and your community safe. As Governor Leon Guerrero said, we are happy you are here. We want you to continue to learn and sharpen your skills with the help of PBS University. This program is the result of a collaborative effort. We couldn't do it alone. I'd like to thank the teachers and support staff of the Guam Department of Education and PBS Guam for their work and their commitment to our students. I'd also like to thank you, students, for participating at home. To your parents, I'd like to thank you for taking an active role in your child's education. We are all eager to return to a time when all of us can share and study together in person. Until then, we hope you learn something new from this PBS University instruction.